Welcome to this session. I will request the presentation started by the speakers. We will start with the session to talk about the WHR installations challenges faced, the practical challenges faced as case studies to be driven by Shri Shyam Asava, the President Projects from Orient Cements with us, Shri Dinesh Kumar, Vice President Production from MP Birla Group, and Shri Ram Chaval, the GM and Head of Production and Process from Lafarge Holcim. Mr. Chaval's presentation is on. Mr. Chaval, you can please proceed and go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Good afternoon, all participants. I thanks Mission Energy, and I understand there are a lot of technical glitches which is going on, and because of that it is delayed. So I will try to discuss it, what are
Yeah, there is a lot of
WHR
technology
installation
learning which we
challenges
need to go through also.
and issues what we. Yeah, so I will be taking on challenge WHRS, and I will be covering some overview and WHR challenges as discussed. Okay, so that Lafarge Holcim is a global building materials and solutions, 72,000 employees, 1,300 operating sites in our countries. We have patents which are out 40% are related to the CO2 carbon footprints, and we are the segments cement, ready mix concrete solutions. Our four values, driver values are simplifications and performance, strength, vision, and the people. 3 point our net sales growth, 1% is our recurring EBITDA growth. Free cash flow is around 49.5%. On invested capital is 7.6. With respect to net carbon dioxide emissions, we are 61 kgs per ton of cement. We are using around 40 tons of waste through our brand. We 299 liters of water, and 9 millions of peoples in the community are benefiting because of Lafarge Holcim. Our few brands recognize Lafarge Holcim is our company. Then it is a conglomeration of Michael, who is doing looking after the alternative fuels and waste management. ACC, Lafarge, Ambuja Cement, these are the well-known brand in India, and these are other brands, selected brand across the world. Okay, now coming back to the WHRS present scenario in Lafarge Holcim, we currently have 5 WHRS units in the 4 countries, and there is a plan to increase 13 more by 2021. We are going very aggressively on WHRS units. Out of this, presently we are having 2 WHR units in India. The total installed capacity is around 4.2 megawatt, and planned for 9 new kilns line, and that will, in addition to existing, it will be around 82 megawatt. So now I will come on what are challenges. So plant selection rationally, on what basis normally plant we select? It is basically the power mix. So where you are getting the power, is it the grid? We have your own CPP and locations, where the location is. Then what is a plant potential? Plant potential will depend on the plant capacity and the specific heat consumption of that respective plant. Okay, then the major challenge is finding the correct WHRS potentials. So for that, we need to have what is the raw material moisture content and fuel moisture content. So in those cases, so you need to do the heat balances and then understand what is heat available. And once we have the heat available, for WHR, means what is the heat requirement for the plant operations, and then what is the extra heat available. Now the next challenge with respect to heat balance also comes the seasonal impact. As we know that in India there is a rainy season, and during rainy season our raw moisture content will change, and we require more heat in the during rainy season. Now on what basis you will going to design? Are we considering the season impact of rainy season where the moisture is very high and then your WHRS capacity remains limited, or you will design for the maximum available heat? So that will be the challenge, and then based on the cost economics analysis for that particular plant, decision can be taken. And also you need to consider the equipment upgradation. Equipment upgradation may be in terms of the preheater. If the preheater outlet temperature is higher, then you can do first of all the process modifications to improve the performance of the preheater cyclones in the preheater side, or it can be done on the cooler side also, like cooler upgradations. What is the cooler recuperation efficiency? Can we increase the cooler recuperation efficiency? And based on that cooler recuperation efficiency, your WHRS potential varies. So that part also needs to be considered while considering the potential for WHRS. Then there are technologies with respect to utilizations of complete heat. Then we call in particular, this is applicable for cooler side, hot air recirculations. So are we going to recirculate total amount of heat or partial amount of heat in the which zone you are going to recirculate this heat, and what is it impacts? There will be possibility that your mid tap temperatures or temperatures for WHRS will increase, but however there will be chance of the possibilities for the reliability issues in the cooler. That has to be considered while considering hot air recirculation. And for the present plant or existing plant, how the cooler load is there for your cooler? If it is heavily loaded, then it is possible that your clinker temperatures will go high, and that will also cause design issues in your clinker silos. That has to be also taken into consideration while considering what kind of system is hot air recirculation. Are we going to do it? Is our cooler is capable of doing that? Because normally the fourth generation cooler or polytrack coolers moving floor coolers. In moving floor coolers, hydraulics are coming below the coolers, and recirculations will be the challenges. So we have to take into considerations OEM, cooler OEM particularly for considering hot air recirculations. And of course, the fan and the civil layout also we have to look into. So that will be the major challenge. Then the challenge is for hot air tap. So there are again different school of thoughts for end tap or single or double mid tap. So what we understand, there is one thing, okay, as a process guy, he knows what is the heat available. But with respect to the, if we consider from the boiler aspects, we understand that, okay, one is the heat and the temperatures. So if we take a mid tap, your compared to end tap, temperature will further increase. And if we take a double mid tap, then your temperature will further increase. So, okay, you will get some reduction in the heat, total heat available, that is MCPDT, but your temperature will increase, and that will increase your boiler efficiency because you are getting high pressure steam because of high temperatures. And then you have to find the optimum level in between that. So to go for double mid tap, single mid tap, or end tap, depending on the power generation potentials you have. So these are few challenges for selecting the correct potential of WHRS. In this particular, particularly the comment will be like this, Ms. WHRS, okay, one can design on effective utilization of CapEx. Let us say I am having 100 kilocalorie heat available, total heat available. And during the summer season and during monsoon season, let us see 90 kilocalories heat is available. In that case, if I want to use 100% utilization of WHRS, then I can consider 90. However, I will be losing 10 kilocalories heat for the remaining months of the year. Let us say 8 months. So depending on capex available, and but this whatever I will be losing this 10 kilocalories, it is for the life of the plant. Okay, I will be losing that 10 kilocalories. But if I'm considering 90 kilocalories, my financial figures will be look very good. So that optimization has to be considered while considering the WHRS potential. Then what are the engineering challenges for the existing plants? As we know that existing plants are very compact, many plants, and there is not, and there are many modifications has been already taken place. So there is not much space in the existing plants. And while taking the cooler takeoff duct, we have the beams, civil structures is there. So that has to be taken into consideration to get the right mid-tap point is the major challenge, right mid-tap opening, getting mid-tap opening, because takeoff velocity, we have to consider the specific takeoff velocity. For those takeoff velocity, we have to have the right size of the opening. And if we are not getting right size of opening, then as we were discussing that a lot of plants are using pet coke as a fuel, and that that is generating the fines clinker. And then if your takeoff velocity is not less than, let us say, 8 meters per second or 10 meters per second, then a lot of re-entrainment of dust will take place. And that will cause the erosion of the, because clinker dust is highly erosion, and erosion of the dampers or in the process that for the operations. So then second comes the pH fan specifications. What should be the design specifications, and what should be the operation operating values for the preheater fan? As we know that with WHRS, our fans pressure will increase, as we were discussing, that 60 to 100 mm depending on your layout of each plant, but your flow is going to reduce. Now, if I look into the fan design or fan characteristic curve, your point, this operating point is going towards the surging zone. And if we are not taking into consideration the point of operation, how the far is it is from the surging zone, then probably if you design the wrong fan, then the operation point will go into the surging zone. Even though we have the high pressure margin, we have to run the fan at higher RPM, which will suck more air from your the system that is in the preheater, and you will get higher temperatures, and it will impact your power consumption of the plant with respect to existing without WHRS and with WHRS, and also the heat consumption if we have higher flow because of this surging issues. Okay, then I already discussed that hot air recirculations, it is causing reliability for, this is for the existing plant particularly. If new plants are there, greenfield plants are there, so those impacts of recirculations will be considered itself while considering the selection of the cooler. And high temperature for existing plant, because we now see that the silo roof of the clinker silo are because when they are designed for certain clinker temperatures, and if we are designing it for very high temperatures, then the structures and all will cause impact on this high temperature. So this is also one of the major point while considering the hot air recirculation in the plant. Of course, the space constraint, because the WHRS required some footprints, and with respect to the WHRS footprints, we need to have proper space, and accordingly we have to adjust the WHRS. So this is one of the major challenge for the WHRS while considering the existing plant. So while assuming, assumptions or considerations will be like, what is your plant is sold out, market conditions, if this is with respect to, okay, we are putting the WHRS, but my plant should be running. So the conditions of the plant, like market conditions, sold out, non-sold out, what is the power available, power cost and all, that kind of things we have to see. Then WHR availability. This is with respect to how much should I will get available based on the moisture conditions or rainy season conditions over that particular plant. Then production rate, it of course, higher the production, we will have the higher potential of WHRS. So, but at the same time, specific heat consumption of that and WHRS convergence. These are some assumptions. What is auxiliary power consumptions? What is raw material fuels consumption? The moisture content for the potentials. These are a few assumptions and considerations for WHRS. And if okay, calculations for WHRS, it is very simple. But major challenge is what we assume. What are our consideration for WHRS, calculating WHRS potentials, considering the technologies? So I think according to me, these are also the challenges. What are what we assume, what we make the assumptions or consideration, also the challenge for the WHRS installations. With this, I finish my presentations. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mission Energy team. And thank you all the participants.
Thank you, Mr. Chawal, for the wonderful insights. I will request Mr. Dinesh Kumar to take it forward. Okay, please proceed.
It is with India's cement industry. What are the manufacturing capacities and what are the WHR potential? So total installed capacity of cement is 550 million ton. It is by 1890 and actual production is 337 metric million ton. It is overview of cement plants in India. Now I come to what are the potential of waste heat recovery plant in India. So you can see present capacity is only 344 megawatt out of 1100 megawatt potential. It is taken 2016 data, which could replace 7 million ton of coal. These are typical cement manufacturing process, which I think everybody knows and I don't need to explain. These are heat losses in cement making process. You can see 20% waste heat of the plant are available for recovery process. This we can see where we can take waste heat from the top of heater and mid tapping from the cooler. That can be converted into energy. Waste heat recovery system. Pyroprocessing clinkerization process takes 1450 degree temperature, approximately 45% of total energy released into the environment, and hot gases released from air quench cooler is approximately 400 or above, and from heater it is on an average 300 and above. So WHRS tapping is taken from heater top and cooler mid tapping. This is a schematic diagram for WHRS power plant. These are boilers, vertical boilers, horizontal tubes, cross flow with thin tube design, better heat transfer, proven design for handling aggressive clinker cooler, condensate preheater introduced to cool the vessel as low as 90 degrees C. You can see an example for cooler mid taping where we can demonstrate how it is converted into power generation. If mid tapping is taken 470 degree temperature and boiler outlet it becomes 150, then steam generation will be 35.9 and power generation will be 6.6 megawatt. Similarly, for a preheater boiler, if total flow is 570,000 NMQ and 265 is outlet temperature, then boiler outlet temperature will be 165. The total heat converted into power will be 6.3 megawatt. Power processing is the only step in process where thermal energy is supplied and utilized. Theoretically, about 390 to 420 kcal of heat is required to form 1 kg of clinker. And other heats being used, that is waste. Some heats are being used for raw material drying and coal drying. and which is not being utilized in our process, that can be converted to waste heat generation. Heat utilization is 6 stage heater. For an example, 5% around 5.0% it is radiation losses. 8.51% is cooler exhaust. 2.53% is clinker losses, and 14.5% is preheater exhaust. You can see 58% of the total heat supply is used for theoretical heat, and this goes out as losses by exhaust gases from preheater, cooler, and with clinker temperature. The heat availability in the preheater exhaust is a function of the preheater gas volume. Depends on amount of excess air used for combustion, implementation to the circuit, specific heat consumption, and type of fuel. Gas temperature depends on heat transfer that is happening in the heater, or number of stages, cyclones, type of cyclones, heater, dust contained in the system, gases, dust contained in the heater gas, technical barrier in utilizing blast heat. Moisture containing raw material. If you have, my raw material containing more moisture, like 10%, 12%, like I have seen some plants in South, so they cannot go for basic recovery plants. But in northern plant where moisture is only 2% or 1.5%, and in rainy season also it is not more than 4-5%, we can go for. Heat requirement of cement additives, quality grade of heat, regions of dust, water availability for waste heat recovery is also to be considered, because we use DM water, and layout constraint and downtime for hook. Layout means if you have one plant and you are going for retrofit, you have to see availability of space in your plant. So WHRS boiler and other equipment, these are technologies for WHRS, Rankine cycle, organic Rankine cycle, and Kalinas. Best one for if your temperature is more than 300 in preheater, Rankine cycle. If you have lower temperature, then you can go for second or third. This is simple diagram, schematic diagram for boilers and from where heat is taken from heater and cooler. 7R methodology adopted for development of WHRS, reduced consumption of resources. If you use WHRS, simply you can reduce the use of fossil fuel. Use of waste material, waste gases. Replace conventional fuel. Whatever fuel you are using, that will be replaced. Release less emission. CO2 emission will be less. Restore to nature what one takes from it. Rethink and relearn, research and development. Performance of WHR plant depends on the following parameters: flow rate of flue gas, inlet temperature of the flue gas into the WHR system, concentration of gas in the gas, limitation in outlet temperature of gas from WHR system, requirement of heat. Raw material to reduce the moisture, variation in the quantity and inlet temperature of flue gas due to process fluctuations, failure of running equipment, breakdown in the section, hookup time for WHRS system after starting the kiln, depends on the operation and maintenance of the WHRS. Challenges faced by cement plants installing the WHRS systems. In house engineering requirement, you have to fit WHRS in current with the current machinery and equipment. WHR vendor identification, execution by in house contracts, interfacing between OEC, operational engineering consultant, and WHR system. Location of unit to minimize distances, layout considerations, hook up during plant setup. So that you have to plan. Technical and financial barriers in operation. Regions of dust in flue gas. hot gas availability and load factor. Adaptability of existing equipment. False air increase and addition power consumption. Non-availability of indigenous supplier and service provider. Non-availability of funds and lack of financial support. Cost per megawatt is approximately 30 to 15 crore per megawatt for installing new WHRS system. RPU benefits are not extended to WHRS informally across the country, despite being widely known for energy efficiency potential as a primary number. Certain states even charge exorbitant levels of electricity duty on WHRS derived power, which discourage its application and potential to improve carbon emissions in industrial operations. It varies state to state. Some states even charges 20 paisa like Karnataka per unit, and some states like MP and Chhattisgarh even charges 95 paisa per unit of the charges. No special incentive, allowance and promotion considered so far for such a potential technology. Technical challenges, type of boiler selection, vertical type, boiler for less space uses, dust separation, disasters are installed, layout, existing cement plant, meter and drawing foundation, vertical boilers for less space uses, existing equipment use of existing fans of cement plant, hookup, readiness of WHR plant and hookup within 5 days, or 7 days as per your system plan. Air cooled condenser required additional use area in cement plant and location of dust free area in cement plant will be a constant. Location in dust, at least least dusty area, you have to ensure maximum possible cost effective heat recovery, dual pressure system, optimum bed taping, less PLF and less availability. Changing size, orientation of ducts, de-dusting, modification in superheaters. These are challenges which should be considered when going for a WHRS system. Maintenance challenges. Because the height of boiler, lifts or approach would be there, lumps, formation or bed formation, right, boiler, that should be taken care of. False air engrossment in boiler, smoke test, dead pans, some bellows, online open ledger should be in place for continuous monitoring of false air. Otherwise, your power generation will come down. Pressure drop in gas path, effective hammering system should be there. High erosion, proper metallurgy because of abrasive material, clinker dust, which is high abrasive. So erosion will be there. That and due to gas velocity also, refractory selection, which type of refractory should be used for less beer, especially in cooler area or duct area, cooler you can say. Bullows area will be most bearing part, so that should be considered. You can see the benefits. Power is available without any emission. Power will be very cheaper if you include your duty, then it will go high certainly state to state, but without duty, it will be even 45 to 60 paise per unit of generation cost. Reducing the greenhouse impact in surrounding environment, saving fossil fuel, which is around 0.8 kg/kg, and same time reduction in CO2 emission, which is 1.2 to 1.4 kg/kWh. Tangible benefits. These are tangible benefits, reduce emission, reduce water consumption, reduce NOx and SOx. Social well-being, employment generation for laborers and professionals, economic well-being, creating business opportunities for technology contractors, environmental well-being, replacing electricity generation from coal, technology well-being, handling highly dusty gases require unique system. Yes. Now we can go for if you have any question, any queries, we can discuss.
Thank you, Dinesh, for the presentation given.
Hello.
Now, Asajari, I'll take you online and I'll share, since you are not able to share your screen, I will share the screen from my side and you can start giving the presentation. Okay. You need to raise your hand when you want the next slide to go.
Yeah. Good afternoon to all. Just I'm giving brief on execution of WHR concept to total complete commission. Next slide, please. I'm just keeping continue. Today's big challenge is basically high fuel and power cost. And second one is reduction of carbon dioxide emissions to reduce global warming. So means being taken is in cement plant around 30 to 35% is lost primarily from the preheater and cooler waste gases. And even considering the heat for drying coal and raw grinding, even 18 to 23% heat is lost, which can be utilized for generation of power by installing waste heat recovery system. Now, if you see the next slides, in which as on date I'm giving the status of overall cement plant in India, as on that installed capacity roughly 550 million ton cement plant. Out of that, as on date cement plant installed capacity 550 million ton. Out of that, around 210 are major cement plant. And if you see overall status of WHR as on date is 77 total number of WHRs order and 53 installed and 24 is under execution. And last 3 years, 39 WHRs installed so far. So considering the fact that there is really good potential in India to install WHRs. Now, next point is nowadays, whenever you go with brownfield expansion or greenfield expansion, MOEF used to put one condition that you have to go with WHRs without any deviations. So there is no options, but in future, all the project will have WHR in that cement plant. Next slide. Now, if you see the total heat input to this average, if you go with a cement plant, roughly 715 kilocalorie, there are good plant which are operating even 690 and even lower than that. But consider the 715 kilocalorie and the main heat required for clinker formation is 410 kilocalorie, preheater exhaust 145, clinker formation 25, radiation losses 50 and cooler exhaust 85 and totally 750. And if you go with percentage, so heat of reaction 58%, preheater exhaust 20 and cooler exhaust is 12, so roughly 32% gases are going through rain to atmosphere. Next slide. Now, out of the 58%, which already I explained, and partly we can, which is utilized for drying raw and coal mill. Next slide. As mentioned, so 220 calorie out of 220 calorie further we can utilize and we can generate waste heat recovery considering 18 to 23% of waste available from preheater after drying and even for a cooler. So same can be utilized for setting up a waste heat recovery system. Next slide. Now, following factor influence for setting up a WHRs. The first important point is fixing the input and output parameter for AQC boiler and SP boiler. This is very, very important. And if you deviate or if any changes, you are going to become a mess on your entire system. And second point is mixing mid-tape location on existing cooler. Second, configuration of WHR with various schemes and adaptability, layout engineering, checking up footprint of AQC and SP boiler, checking fouling of foundation, mechanical structure, electrical instrumentations, utilities, etc. for brownfield project, then inlet and outlet ducting layout and bypass arrangement and integration of existing system, selection of temper, type of material, constructions, etc., water treatment, selection of turbine. Next line, please. Piping layout, selection of auxiliary equipment, selection of supplier, fixing of performance guarantee, performance test procedures, construction challenges, because when your plant is operational with limited space, there are many changes, and you have to execute or construct entire without disturbing existing plant. Then interconnections of electrical with cement plant process, interconnection with the existing DCS with operation system, then interconnection of dust extraction system for with the cement plant, execution of entire project with the safety of manpower, then machines and others. Next slide. Now, if you, I just want to accept, because everybody is known on the mass process and main process, and already explained by other colleagues. So next slide. Now, if you go with the boiler, there are options available: vertical cross flow, horizontal cross flow, and vertical cross flow, which is no more available, and AQC boiler, vertical cross flow, and vertical cross flow. But most of all the cement plant, you will find all are having vertical cross flow boiler, AQC and SP. Next. These are photographs which you can see. Next. Next. Now, in this slide, you can see, based on the, if you are having the greenfield project, then there is no constraint. And if even in greenfield project and future, you keep provision, then you have to keep provision for your SP boiler as well as a TG, as well as AQC boiler. But in case if you don't have a provision, then you have to plan available space nearby the pyro or preheater. In that case, there will be pressure drop by taking the gases and back to system. So carefully, we have to check all the parameters at the time of finalization of WHRS. Next. Next. Now, first important point is, when you are going with a brownfield or even a brownfield project, so you have to check heat and mass balance under various conditions, rated and potential capacity. And you have to go, you have to select with the potential capacity of WHRS. Now, even theoretical, as my other colleague also mentioned, that we need hot gases for raw grinding as well as coal grinding. And theoretical, we need roughly 540 kilocalorie per kg of moisture. And but when you go with a system plus a different technology, then even false entry, roughly you need 750 to 850 kilocalorie of heat per kg of moisture. So we have to take care while designing the WHRS outlet temperature of boiler, so that it can dry raw meal or coal without any issue. Otherwise, you are going to face problem. And secondly, when we used to go with designing the entire system, we used to go with bypass system. So in bypass systems, whenever in rainy seasons, when we face these challenges, we partly bypass the hot gases so that we can get higher temperature, few gases to dry raw meal as well as coal. Next slide. So this is the concept which I just indicated, that if you go with various percentage of moisture in, throughout the month, only in rainy seasons you are going to face challenges for drying this. And second, in rainy, most of the cement plant, you will find that rainy season is practically lean period in which there is less production. So carefully, we have to consider designing of WHRS accordingly, so that you will not face challenges and you can better utilize entire available hot gases to generate more power. Next. Now, there are three type of technology available in the, particularly this WHRS, but most of WHRS supplied industry employ the Rankine cycle. And in Rankine cycle, if you go with like ideally 6,500 to 7,000 to this, critical parameters are flue gases, temperature from cooler, and these outlet temperature of cooler as well as a preheater. But when we are considering the preheater top, we should consider inlet of boiler so that we can get better. And next point, important point, is boiler outlet in cooler. If you go, normally people used to go with 90 to 150. If you are going to recirculation, then you have to go with 90. Otherwise, you have to go with higher temperature at the time of considering design, so that considering emission and to control emission, we used to also install cyclone in cooler circuit as well, so that there'll be less dust load on ESP and we can meet outlet emissions. Same way, in particularly preheater, this 140 to 180 degree, which is very, very important to consider the design of the room. These are the main parameters for designing of your WHRS. If you deviate on these, you will get low output or more output, and then you face many challenges. So you have to carefully check with your heat balance, operating parameters, plus you can take help from OEM to get better all operating parameters and other things. Next slide, please. As you mentioned that in particularly conventional steam cycle, there are single pressure system, dual pressure and phase system, and non-conventional organic Rankine cycle, Kalina cycle. Now I'm just, because most of all Indian plant are having Rankine cycle, and in the Rankine cycle, there are two options. One is single pressure and dual pressure. In dual pressure, you, from evaporator again gases pass to boiler. So whenever the gap between preheater outlet temperature as well as room inlet temperature, gases temperature, if there is difference is more than, we should go with dual pressure, otherwise single pressure. So most of cement plant, though even if we are having six stages or five stages, used to go with a dual pressure cycle. So while selections, we should think on which cycle we should go, and that will impact on overall cost as well as power. Next slide, please. Now, if you go with like a comparison with a single pressure, phase drive and dual pressure, we'll find power output in dual more power. Turbine operating life is also more. No doubt, because of dual circuit, cost will be high. Reliability is more or less high and medium. No issue on reliability. Next slide. Now, these are the scheme which I just showing. So I don't want to discuss on this because of time constraint. So I think we can go next. This is dual pressure cycle. Next. This is phase system. Next. Now, if you go with the comparison between Rankine, Organic and Kalina cycle, first is thermal fluid. Rankine, we used to go water. And Organic sign, we used to go with pentane or thermic fluid, and Kalina ammonia plus water. Now, the why in Organic cycle and Kalina, these to go pentane and this, because of their boiling temperature. Normally, pentane and ammonia will find the boiling temperature is roughly 33 or 36 degree, while water boiling temperature is 100. So, with a low heat, even you can operate the WHRS and you can generate power. However, there are different challenges for safety, plus leakage, plus operation, and many other things, plus investment. So considering all these things, I can say 99% in India or worldwide, you'll find Rankine cycle is more popular. So that's why in all cement plant, you'll find maximum this, and in ordinary cycle, as on that, there is in third party, Ultratech, they install ordinary. After that, even they change to Rankine cycle, all the WHRS. Next slide, please. This is the instant Rankine flow, which I right now it's very detailed, so I don't want to discuss on this. But this is the concept on Rankine cycle, how it moves at this. Next, this is Organic, and this is Kalina. All these three cycles, these and people can go through, and in case if for any clarification, can discuss further. Next. Now, as mentioned, following scheme were adopted now. Most of cement plant in India, conventional scheme means with Rankine cycle, dual pressure with vertical cross flow AQC and SP boiler preheater bypass system. This is the commonly adopted by most of cement plant. Now, few cement plant also adopted hot air recirculation scheme in which exhaust gases from cooler ESP will recirculate to cooler from cooler fan to generate more power. Now, carefully we have to check, because when you are going with recirculation, you have to increase, you have to change your all fans, major fans, and in which you have to increase more power, plus you will get more clinker temperature and challenges in storing your clinker stockpile, and also more wear and tear. And finally, at the end, you will find that overall cost is more installation as well as operating rather getting generation of the power. So carefully we have to adopt this, and there are many cooler which are not even adopt this type of scheme. So even prior to proceeding on this, carefully we have to check technology of the cooler, and we have to discuss with OEM whether we can go with this hot air recirculation. Else then we can and adopt. And if you go with a like a 7,000 ton plant by hot recirculation, roughly you can get additional power 0.8 megawatt. Next, this there are many plant they used to put like HAG and TAD. The idea is to increase the temperature. So in either interstate radiator, and sometimes people use bypass system hot gases to generate more waste heat power. So this is the scheme which carefully we have to select even at the time of planning for WHRs in whether it is greenfield or brownfield. Next slide, please. So this is aqueous boiler. What are the three, four scheme which I mentioned? I just draw all the sketches so carefully you can check how where we are going to install, whether it is in aqueous boiler with dual input. Next slide. This is a hot air recirculation from cooler. Next. This is a scheme with hot air generator by putting additional firing in which we can fire coal or even diesel. But one important point I would just like to highlight that once we decide to put this scheme, we have to take environment clearance and approval accordingly, because MOEF only used to give clearance to utilize waste without any secondary firing. So we should carefully check before finalization of this scheme, based on our approval. Next slide, please. Now, performance of WHRs depend upon various parameters in your plant, like as mentioned, the flow rate of flue gases, then inlet temperature of flue gases in WHR system, concentration of dust in gases, limitations in outlet temperature of gas from WHR system, requirement of raw grinding and coal grinding, various in the quantity and inlet temperature of flue gases due to process filtration, failure of the running equipment, breakdown in kiln sections, hookup, time for WHR system after starting the kiln, operating challenges, operational maintenance of WHRs, availability of skilled manpower, all of the depend your performance on WHRs. There are ways to take care of all these parameters, and we can operate the WHRs efficiently without any issue. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, water requirement. Normally, in waste heat recovery, we don't need more water. However, for theoretical or even getting approval, we need roughly 0.3 to 1 meter cube per hour per megawatt. So this is the water, and which is easily manageable in most of all the plants without any issue. Next slide. Execution schedule. Normally, whether it is green or brownfield, if you go with greenfield, so 15 to 18 months time, we can execute a complete result without any issue. And if you go with the brownfield, so same in 15 to 18 months, independent, we can complete. And 12 to 15 days time is required for hookup along with the kiln major shutdown. So, but this need exhaustive planning in all the front, whether it is electrical, mechanical process and this, but can be this without any issue. Next. Now, if you go with a list of vendor, in earlier days, we used to go with a maximum with a Chinese vendors due to low capex, as well as they have more experience. But now, last 6-8 years, Indian supply also geared up in technology and supplied many WHRs, and easily we can tap. And today's situation, if you import from China or any part of the world, is more costly compared to Indian vendors. And if you go with the reputed like Thyssen, TKIL, Thermex, Isjek, Transparent, Sinoma, Mitsubishi, AVI, these are the vendors we can discuss with all and get better deal in techno-commercial ways. Next. When we are planning to go with WHRs, we have to take prior approval from Pollution Control Board. Then we have to take approval from Factory Inspector. We have to take from State Electricity Board, and we have to take Indian boiler regulations. because these are the main and balance based on the requirement we have to take April on all that part. Next slide. Now, estimated cost of WHRC is roughly 10 to 11 crore per megawatt. And if you go with a CPP, it's roughly 4.5 to 5 crore per megawatt. So normally most of cement plant in past, they used to go along with CPP, but they used to keep provision for WHRs in future. But now today, most of all the greenfield plant used to go with the WHRs, or sometimes they used to go with combination of WHRs plus solar power, which is one of the best options available in India along with the grid. So this is while evaluating financial techno-commercial feasibility report, we have to take carefully check with investment versus operating cost. Now, if you go with operating cost of WHRs, roughly it will be 40 paisa to 50 paisa per unit, while in WHRs, while in CPP, you will get roughly 4 to 4.5 rupees per this without considering interest and depreciation. And again, if you are only taking power from grid, then the cost of power will be much, much more. I'm unable to see. Normally for such type of WHRs, payback shall be within a period of around 4 years. Again, depend upon the power cost, whether grid tariff, your CPP cost, etc. But definitely it is good and viable project. Next. Now, benefit of installing WHRs already covered by my other colleagues. It can reduce carbon footprint roughly 75,000 ton per annum CO2 generation of 6,500 to 7,000 plant. We can also get carbon credit, but again, prior approval and other things. Emitting less temperature flue gases to atmosphere, resultant reduction in atmosphere temperature. Power generation cost WHR is much, much lower compared to grid as well as CPP. It helps in saving water in case of the people, those who are having gas conditioning tower or high temperature gases, and they are using water to reduce flue or hot gases temperature, help to meet environment compliance, also help to reduce overall contract demand from grid. And there are many significant benefits. Next. This is end of my presentations. So thanks to all for discussing on this topic. And now we can, any questions, we can discuss.
Thank you, Shyam Asavaji, Dinesh Kumarji. I think we have lost connectivity with Ram Chavalji. Let me see if he's there. I could bring him there. So I think we've lost connection with him. So we will take the questions for the audience now. I have a couple of questions sub in chat. I'm providing the mic to Mr. Vikram Dev Singh Chandel, the senior manager from New Vista Limited, formerly Emami Cement Limited.
This is Vikram Singh Chandel.
I will yes, please me. Go ahead.
What is the meaning of this HAG and PAD bond? This question from Mr. Shyam Asma.
Okay, the meaning of
how do you
okay,
how meaning of how it will work.
Okay. Say the meaning of HAG is hot air generator. So in which we can fire fuel and increase the gas temperature so that we can get more temperature from gases. And there are ways where we can fire the gases on the system. Now second, which I mentioned, TAD. TAD is tertiary air duct, which carries hot gases from cooler to calciner, in which we can fire secondary fuel so that we can get tertiary air duct more temperature.
Sir, pardon, second question, sir. Is it beneficial for operating the WHR with fire with coal in the or TAD boiler? Is it beneficial?
Yeah, there are many plants. Suppose they are not, if the plant are not having CPP and they are only having grid power, in that case, if you go with secondary firing, which is very less cost, then you can generate more power. So it's again techno-commercial evolution. How are you going to compare? If you are going with a CPP, your own captive power plant, coal-based plant, then it is not beneficial. But if you are comparing with grid, yes, it is beneficial.
So this is only beneficial for those who don't have any captive power plant, and with compare the cost respect with grid. Sir, is this is legal? This firing is legal?
No, that's why I mentioned that you have to take approval at the time of taking environment clearance plus other clearance that we are going with secondary. And in my presentation, I mentioned that in MOU, when you present your case, they used to give approval considering that you will not use secondary fire to generate waste heat recovery power. So practically, if you get permission from authority, then you can go. Otherwise, it is illegal.
Okay, thank you, sir.
The question is from Mr. Mukesh, General Manager from RCCPL. He is asking, can you please describe the significance of null point and how it is changed?
Sir, there is one more question from Mr. Ram Chawal.
Just a minute. The question for Mr. Asawa by Mr. Mukesh was, can you please describe the significance of null point and how it changes the effects clean and cooler?
Now, null point is the point where you will get your gas velocity is practically very less, and if you will deviate from that is midpoint of cooler, and if you deviate, then it's very difficult to control your gases. If you deviate from your null point, then what happened from cooler, the gases which are going to kill as well as a TA duct will not go, and maximum gases will even divert and it will go to your AQC boiler. So that's why this is very, very important. And even after doing all these things, we used to adjust through the damper and balance all the heat, all the gases flow. And second important point is we have to calculate theoretical of temperature while designing the null point. So normally we can easily in brownfield even plant or brownfield project, we know outlet gas temperature, cooler inlet, TAB inlet. However, it is very difficult to just so carefully, theoretically, we have to calculate. Also, sometimes we used to make some arrangement and measure the gas temperature. That's why we used to go 500, and there are many plants, they used to go with even 550 or 600 at null point, like Siri Cement. And in today's, if you go with Siri Cement, they are generating more power from waste heat recovery. I'm giving just an example.
26
megawatts,
sir?
No. I'm just giving an example. 10,000 or 12,000 plant recently they commissioned in Gulbarga area. They are generating roughly 28 to 30 megawatt power, which is nobody can even accept that they can generate, but yes, they are generating.
Dinesh Jagetia, you can proceed further. I'm giving the mic to you.
Good afternoon, sir. This question is to Mr. Ram Chawal, sir. Sir, as you were discussing, is that what are the best efficiencies available for WHR and what is the best auxiliary power consumption data you are available?
Mr. Sahil, there's some problem with your audio. We are not able to hear you. Can anybody else answer the question of Mr. Jagadia?
Okay.
Sir, power consumption will range from 5 to 7% normally.
And the boiler efficiencies, WHR efficiencies, how much we are getting it, sir?
Total efficiency, if you go over, it will be 17 to 20% only. Whatever heated level, that will be only 17 to 20% will be able to convert into power.
Okay.
Can I take the next question, Mr. Dinesh?
Yes, sir.
I'm giving the mic to Mr. Vijay Kumar Kunche. Mr. Kuche, please go ahead.
Hello. Can you hear me?
We can hear you. Please go ahead. No problem.
Yeah, this is Vijay Kumar from First Esco. Sir, I want because capacity utilization determines the viability of the waste heat recovery.
Whom the question is?
Could you please elaborate, sir? For all the members, sir. All the
okay, team. All the
Shyam Asawa and Ram Chawal.
Who would like to answer?
Everybody wants to.
Sir, you are not audible, sir.
Mr. Chawal, I think there is a problem with your headphone.
I'll reply. See, rightly you said that capacity utilization of WHRC directly depend upon your performance of your kiln. Now, suppose you are operating kiln throughout the year, 345 or 340 days, then you can remove around 10 to 12 days because when you start the kiln, you need a heating time, like say 12 to 14 hours or even 24 hours based on the refractant and other things. So that time you can't generate WHRs. Rest all time you can generate power from waste heat recovery system without any issue. This is one point. Second, as mentioned, in particularly rainy season, when there'll be more moisture content in raw and coal, then you have to divert some hot gases bypassing through boiler. That time capacity utilization of boiler will be less. So even considering all these factors, you can definitely get payback period roughly around 4 years.
Is that clear, Mr. Vijay Kumar Kunche? Or you would like to answer, ask another question?
Sir, my second question is, are you interested in installing ORC systems for your waste heat recovery, sir? Have you been exploring?
Which one?
Organic Rankine cycle.
No. Because as mentioned, it's a very, very expensive and there are big risks on this. So even if you go with ammonia, even pentane, and particularly based on the conditions of technology and other things, there are chances of leaks and other things and maintenance costs. So that's why nobody is exploring. And today all are going with water. Even suppose leakage, it will not damage. But other is really...
But in Europe, many plants have installed. In Europe, many cement plants have installed ORC systems. Would you be interested if we can offer similar systems here in India, sir?
Mr. Kunche, every technology cannot work everywhere. And I'm sure we are not here to ask about the offerings, but ask questions about the technology. Thank you. I'll take the mic next, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Amol Kamadi, you can go ahead and from Gujarat Siddhi Cement.
Yes, sir. Can you hear
me? We can hear you, sir? And whom you would like to question this for?
My question to Shyam Asawa, sir.
Yes, please.
I want to ask one. First of all, I want to know where is WHR operated with HAG, sir, in India?
I think there are two plants. I'll just come back. Let me check. In India, there is two plants with a TAD firing and HAG firing.
Then, sir, what is the difference between WHR and the coal fire boiler, that ABC and CABC boiler? This is totally WHR. This is waste heat. Whatever the cement plant, on that basis, we generate the power. That means waste heat recovery power plant. Once we install the HAG, that means this is not a WHR, sir.
No, you are absolutely right. The permission granted for WHRs. However, to get more power, if people are not having their own CPP and they are taking power from grid, they used to increase more temperature flue gases. So that's why they used to go with secondary firing. That's why in my presentation, I clearly mentioned that we have to take all approval. Otherwise, authority will not allow to go with the WHRs because rightly you mentioned it is purely waste heat recovery system and secondary firing is not allowed.
That's why I'm saying, sir, that the boiler design is totally different, just like a ABC and CABC boiler. This is not a WHR boiler, sir.
No, agreed. I'm not denying because what we are doing, they are examples like tear duct. In tear duct, they put nozzles and they go with a diesel firing. Then what happened? So temperature of gases will further increase and definitely exhaust temperature completely will more and they can generate more power.
But that till I don't know where is it operated WHR with this HEG. Please share that.
I'll share, but even if you have connections, you can explore in Sili Cement. They did also, and I'll also share these things.
If the installation cost of HEG is very less, then actually in Sili Cement operated 5.5 megawatt, and this is a totally WHR boiler. So if it is possible, if after installation of HEG and we run the turbine, because what happens, the cement plant is tripped, that time WHR also tripped. With yeah. this help of HEG, the turbine will not be tripped. Just we can run the turbine with minimum load with this help of HEG. So I want to ask that in India, if this is possible, HEG, with this HEG, we operate the generate the power. So it is, there is the two benefits. We will generate the power continuously without tripping, after tripping the cement plant also. Another thing, so we generate the more power also.
You are right. I'll come back on this. But yes, in Sili Cement, they are using secondary firing to get more power. As mentioned, even in an 11,000 ton plant, they are getting roughly 28 to 30 megawatt. So they are doing this, and I'll come back on
Mr. Sabha will be available on the Mission Energy's mobile app to answer the first question. And the app is available for you, Mr. Kamadi, to network and ask technical questions future. With shortage of time, I would like to take the next question.
Okay, thank you, sir.
I am giving the mic to Mr. Vivek Vikram Dev Chandel again.
Okay. Total WHR is operation maintenance cost around 40 cents only per unit. Okay. But duty on that generation is almost 1 rupees. Hello. Total cost हमारे WHRS का 40 पैसे से 50 पैसे जाता है generally. But 1 rupee हमें उसका electricity duty pay करना पड़ता है. तो ऐसा कोई state है इंडिया में जहाँ पे duty waiver off है? या ऐसा कोई planning है कि duty के लिए waiver off के लिए हम लोग application दे रहे हैं?
As per my knowledge, there is no change in duty. We have to pay the duty. All the if you go with even grid, if you go with a CPP, or if you go with this. So I don't foresee. And when we are comparing with overall operating cost, that means if you go with like a coal-fired CPP, your cost is like around 4.5, and here is 40. So we are only comparing with operating cost. All other are going to remain same, like interest deficit based on the capex is going to remain same. Other things is going to remain same. So at the end, with additional investment, with a benefit, we are getting payback period.
Okay. So probably we have no further questions for the speakers, and we're running with the short with the time because of the technology constraints. I probably would request everybody to give a round of applause to all the speakers. And if any speaker in the future is finding a trouble in giving the presentation, I'll request them to share the presentation to me so that I can run the presentation from here as I help Ms. Asava. Thank you all. We'll take a break. I hope you enjoy the networking tables now. And we will assemble back shortly. Thank you all.
Okay. Thanks a lot to the entire team.